Alright, welcome back for our day two. We're trying to get the limited test drive, which needs about 1,000, I believe it's kilometers on this particular truck. And I did go ahead and drive over here to this garage. We're going to go ahead and pick that up. And our money's probably going to shoot up here in a minute because we're still in queue to get on the server. There was about 3,000 people online. So I'm expecting our money to probably shoot up here in a minute. Yeah, I guess I can't skip that. I was trying to skip it. Let's see if I can try escape. There we go. Yeah, I guess we need some cargo. Yeah, get that parking brake on. I'd like to get some cargo going up to the northwest. Of course, I also want to make sure that we get one that's going to be about 1,000 kilometers. That would probably do it. Let's see what else we've got here. You know what? That would be a real good drive, I think. That way we could open up some of the map over there. I'll tell you what, it's been one of those weeks. Been having quite a bit of internet problems. I was hoping it'd fix itself, and it looks like it might have, but we'll just have to wait and see. I really don't like having to call them. They did, that's right, the lights are out because we're still offline. We've got about 207 in queue, so it might be a minute. Excuse me. Might be a minute, and I'm expecting our money to jump up. I hope it doesn't, but I'm sure it probably will, because it's been a few days since I've logged in. I would like to be in a parking lot when we do get online, because I don't want to be out here driving and all of a sudden there's traffic out here. That wouldn't be good. Yeah, speaking of being one of those weeks, one thing that went wrong is I went to the store knowing that it was probably going to snow sometime this week. I was like, well, I would really like to get a few things. And of course, when I got to the store, they were sold out. I was like, well, all right, I'll wait a couple of days and hopefully the truck will be there. And went back up there on the day that it snowed, which was yesterday. You know, I wanted to get out before it got bad because, yeah, people have a tendency to have a few more wrecks on days where it's raining or snowing, so I figured, well, I'll get out there and hopefully they'll have it. Well, I got out there and they didn't have it. They said that the truck was supposed to have been in that day, so it looks like I gotta wait a little bit longer. So that was one thing that went wrong. Oh, they did update the server, I noticed. I had to download a new patch, and it was kinda cool because it looks like now we've got a new launcher, so hopefully we don't have to go to the website anymore. We can just update right through the launcher. And that's going to be quite the drive. I know exactly what I did wrong. Alright, let's get off the highway real quick. I forgot to select the starting city where I wanted to pick the cargo up from. We'll just pull over here and redo it. Was that a Dutes back there? I couldn't tell. It was green and black. Most Dutes are green. Or at least the ones in game. I don't know about real life. Yeah, this'll do. We're out of everybody's way. To be was right there. Yeah, that'll work right there. So now we're gonna have to turn around and go back. Question is, how far do I have to go before I can actually turn around? That might be a little bit of a problem. Yes, they updated the launcher, and like I said, hopefully we can just get our updates through that, because going through the website and downloading and relaunching the game, it's not bad, but yeah, I feel like it could be done a little bit better. So hopefully that's what they've done. I wonder if I can get off up here. No connection is reestablished, so how did our money do? Okay, it didn't shoot up. Awesome. I'm glad there was nobody around when we connected to the server. Hopefully we can make this work. Nope, can't get off. Man, I really want to turn around. Yeah, if I hadn't bought that garage when I started out, then I would just cut the video and redo the whole thing. Since I've already bought the garage and spent the money, I don't really want to do that. Maybe if we get lucky, we can turn around right here. It looks like it's going to be guardrails all the way. That's not cool. Yep. All right, keep on going. If it gets to the point where we get closer to another city, then I might just go ahead and pick up our trailer in a different city instead of that one. Because we're getting kind of far out there now. Oh, more things that happened. Well, when I download the launcher, and I'm not going to blame the launcher. It could have just been one of those things. My Xbox controller stopped working. So I had to disconnect it and reconnect it to get that to work and download the drivers again. So that was a bit of a mess. I'm not going to blame the launcher. That is when it happened, but I'm not going to blame the launcher for that, because I did have another issue that came up before I even downloaded the launcher, and that was having problems with my recording software. For whatever reason, every great once in a while I have to reboot the computer. Because I leave my computer on pretty much 24/7, unless, there's going to be some storms or I'm expecting a power outage or something. I leave her running, because I do have a backup battery, unless I'm going to be away from the house for a while. Oh, when that backup battery goes off, that's annoying. I mean, it's worse than most fire alarms. It is pretty stinking loud. Yeah, also, like I said, I've also been having problems with the internet, and it was really unusual. It was the same time last year that I had problems with my internet. Of course, last year, it was my upload speed that was messed up, and it was messed up to a point that it was actually affecting the download as well. They said there was noise in the lines, and until they could actually find out where it was located, there wasn't much they could do. That was a bit of a downer, because what they said is it could be as simple as somebody plugging something into the internet that they weren't supposed to. One guy said that he had found that a lady had stuck a regular telephone cable and jammed it inside where the internet goes, and it was causing... Oh boy, which way do I actually want to go? Let's keep going straight, like I have a choice now, but... I think we'll go to Wien. Why not? We're almost there. Oh boy. I'm sitting there looking at the mini-map. And I'm glad there's nobody around. So yeah, he said that somebody had jam something into a regular phone line into where the internet goes. That's two different size cables, and it was causing noise interference, and it took them forever, a couple of weeks to track it down. And it was disrupting a lot of people's internets. The problem I'm having this time is the exact same thing, but it's not interfering with the download, which I find that to be a bit on the odd side. It's okay today. The upload's okay today. In the past, it was messed up. It's been messed up for about a week now. And that's what's been hindering getting my videos up, because, you know, I could start the download and it would say it was going to take, you know, an hour long video would take probably about 2 hours to upload, and I was okay with that. But then 5 minutes later it'd start saying it was going to take 3 hours, and then 4 hours, and then it would just cut out. So I'd have to go in and delete the video and re-upload it. So that's why I haven't been getting very many up there. Normally I try to aim for about 2 to 3 a day, and sometimes if they're not an hour long, I can get 4 or 5 up there. It really depends on how long the videos are. That may have been what was also interfering with a live stream. So once this all clears up, I might actually try doing a live stream again. Am I going to be going the right way? It looks like if it'll curve to the right. I'm hoping it doesn't go. Okay, good. I was kind of worried that maybe it was going to go over the highway and then curve back to the left. I didn't want to do that. Almost the win, and then we'll pick up a cargo. Yeah, so we've got to drive about 1,000 kilometers. The one thing though, this driving that we're doing now is not going to count. You actually have to be pulling a trailer. You have to be doing the mission itself. Hopefully we can find one that's about 1,000 kilometers out. We've done about 150, I think, so far, but if we can find one that's about 1,000 kilometers out, we can actually finish this and not drag it out for another day. Okay, we're getting pretty close. Yeah, the trouble I had last time with my internet, it was insane. I went through probably 30 phone calls trying to get it straightened out. You know, they'd send somebody out to my house. And of course, I also helped my mom across the street with her internet, and she was having the exact same issues. So I figured, well, we'll just call for both the areas at the same time. And that was a bit of a mistake, because, you know, sometimes they'd show up at my house for her problem and then say, okay, well, we can't do it because we're at the wrong address. See you next time. And they'd show up over there and they're supposed to be working over here. And of course, same thing, you know, they show up for the wrong address, so they're not going to do the work. Once we got that straightened out, I can believe that. Once we got that straightened out, you know, they'd come over here and they'd say, well, we think it's probably your modem. So they'd replace the modem. And of course, that didn't fix the issue. The next guy that comes out, yeah, okay, I think I found the problem. You've got a splitter here. And I was like, well, all right, fine. Go ahead, take the splitter off. I don't need it anyways. And of course that didn't fix the problem, so I got a little bit smarter. I hooked directly into the internet itself. You know, I took off my router and all that, and running my test, of course the problem wasn't fixed, so I called them back out, and they decided that they were going to replace all the connectors on the outside of the box. They said it had been probably 2 or 3 years since it had been done. They said that sometimes that can cause interference, so they went ahead and replaced that, and that didn't fix the problem. So sent somebody else out, and they said, well, we think it's your modem. I was like, well, the last guy, you know, well, a couple of guys back, he replaced our modem. He's like, well, yeah, this modem's kind of outdated. We need to get you on the DOSIX 3.0. I was like, all right, that'll work. So they replaced the modem, and that didn't fix it. And called up there again, had them come back out, and they said, well, we're going to run a new line from the pole, the tap, and run it all the way back into your house. I was like, oh, sweet. Can't beat that. You get a whole new line for free. That didn't fix the problem, and on top of that, I had to wait about another week and a half, I think, for them to actually come out and bury the cable. So once that was done, called them back out, and probably about another 3 or 4 times, them trying to troubleshoot everything. One of them actually came out was a. That's another thing. They were getting. Oh my goodness! I was supposed to stop back there at Wyan. This is going to be a mess. All right, I'm gonna pull off right up here where we are supposed to be transforming onto the other highway and see what I can figure out. Let's just pull off right here. Plenty of room for people to get around us, so. Yeah, talking and driving at the same time just doesn't work out, does it? Not for me. Alright, so I'd like to start at Wien this time. Oh my goodness. Alright, you know what? We're going to fix this right now. I forgot all about this. We'll just hit F7 and call out a tow truck. I should have done this a while ago. Now, let's get our cargo from wherever we are at. I'll be happy. Alright, we're at Wien. That'll work. We're going to set our GPS from Wien, pick up our cargo at Wien. Oh wow, our money did shoot up. Now we've got 54 million. Okay, well, we're going to pretend like we don't have 54 million and deal with 178,000. Was train of thought on that. They were sending out it would be the cable company, and sometimes it would, wow. I don't know if you guys can see that or not. He was going past us, and I saw him going past us, but I didn't realize he had a wreck right there. Driving a little too fast going around that corner. Let's go ahead and run the red light. Sometimes they'd send out the cable company, and other times they would send out the contractors. The cable company, they do a fairly decent job, a thorough job, but when they would send out the contractors, those are the guys that would say, well, we think it's your motor, or we think it's your splitter, or whatever. The cable company, they actually do a fairly decent job when they come out trying to troubleshoot it. And towards me getting frustrated at the end, they actually finally sent out a supervisor, which is what I've been asking them to do for the longest time back then. And they sent out one of the supervisors. He couldn't find anything wrong. He said, yeah, it looks like there is a little bit of noise in the line, but I can't really diagnose it. You know, I don't really have the tools with me, but we'll send out another supervisor. And of course, you know, they actually sent out contractors. Eventually, I finally did get a supervisor out here, the second supervisor, and it amazed me. He opened up his tablet right there in the middle of the street and said, yeah, I can see there's a huge noise interference. Of course, unfortunately, you know, we're going to have to figure out where it's coming from. It's not something that I can fix today, but I'll definitely put in a ticket for them to come and look at the lines. You know, he's just a supervisor. He just diagnoses problems. Oversees things and diagnoses. He doesn't actually do the work himself. Yeah, right there on an open tablet. Didn't have to connect to the line or anything. Just opened up his little computer there and said, yep, I can see it right here. And it amazes me that particular tool, I feel like, should be a tool that when you call somebody out, they should have that. But unfortunately, he said, no, that's something that they only allow the supervisors to have, and when you call, you're not guaranteed to get a supervisor out here. So that's what happened last year at about this same time, and that's kind of what I've been going through, except I haven't been losing internet totally. It's just been the upload. All right, let's see if we can pick this up. Starting to concentrate. Gotta be quiet while we concentrate. We'll pull out here and set our destination. Yeah, that's probably good enough. I won't spend too much time, but there is one area, I think it was right over in here, yeah. Oh boy, this is gonna be a long trip. Okay, let's go through here. I'll try not to make this too long. Let's get off the highway right there. That's not gonna work, never mind. We'll stick with that, I think. And that should be all of the gray road. Alright, real quick, going over it. Yeah, I think that'll probably do. There's going to be a lot more trips that we're going to make. That'll be an interesting one right there. Yeah, I don't see any more gray roads that we're missing. Alrighty, let's get started. Oh, parking brake. See if we can get there, be able to talk, and not have a whole lot of issues. Yeah, this time around it's still the upload that's causing the problem, but at least I'm not getting disconnected. And the reason I haven't called it in yet is because I've had so many problems in the past. I'm just kind of hoping that it'll work its way out and they'll figure out what's going on their own without me calling in. And the last time I went from, it was about the beginning of November, and it didn't clear itself up until sometime in January to February. I got so fed up, I didn't even play online games or anything. I just played single player games and did the best I could. Popped on to various games. They were great once in a while, seeing if it cleared up yet. Yeah, I just got so frustrated. I mean, I was to the point where I actually started recording some of the phone conversations. Of course, I can't really do anything with it, but just to refresh my memory on what all had been said, what all they were doing. And I actually wrote down some things that I had planned on filing a complaint with. And that was an issue in itself, because I was going to file a complaint, and the way I went about doing it is I called the customer service line and I told them that I wanted to, you know, I was getting ready to file a complaint and I wanted to speak with somebody so I could get all the information down. And of course she was extremely hesitant on wanting to transfer me in the first place. And finally, when I did get transferred to the place where you're supposed to give them that information, I was like, okay, well, I guess we'll do it over the phone, you know. So I listed everybody that I had contact with, you know, roughly what they'd said, the work that had and hadn't been done. And I just, when the phone conversation was over, I felt dismayed. I was like, you know what, how do I even know that that complaint got filed? You know, were they just actually listening to me and not doing anything because of all the problems I've had in the past? There was no way for me to know, so I kind of gave up on that. The only other option you have is, of course, to file it with the Better Business Bureau, and that's really not going to get a whole lot done. Matter of fact, I did look on the Better Business Bureau, and I was a bit distraught when I saw that, because most of it was negative complaints about the cable company that I have, and there weren't that many. That's what shocked me. I was like, there's millions of people with the same cable company and there's not that many people that are reporting issues. I found that interesting. And the ones that did report it, that in itself was amazing, because what happens when they report it, they send out information back to the cable company saying, hey, are you willing to work with these people? This is what's going on, whatever, you know. And the cable company would get back with them saying, okay, well, we're going to pay attention to you. What seems to be your problem? And it just, you know, it kind of would go back and forth. Of course, they don't give you detailed information about what went on, but it's enough that you get an idea. And I was like, man, these people are having the exact same issue that I'm having. And the answers that they're getting is the exact same answers I was getting, and it wasn't getting them anywhere. And I think excuse me, I think they finally just gave up on it, waited for it to get fixed. But I'm content with it right now. It does seem to be working. I've run the speed test, which in itself is a little bit of a joke. As a matter of fact, I even had one guy out here that I was showing him the speed test, and he's like, man, speed tests are they're such a messed up tool, you know, everybody relies on it. And I was like, alright. So I had to get some things in gear. I found a tool that I could download that would run, basically it would ping servers and stuff. You could tell it where you wanted it to ping. It would tell you where your packet loss is and all that. It's a program called Ping Plotter, I believe it was. And that was a real interesting tool. Granted, I don't know a whole lot about it. I still know enough about it that I was able to see that there was definitely a problem. Like, of course, I couldn't figure out where it was at. It doesn't give you that kind of information. It just tells you where your packets are being lost at. So, that was one of the more widely known things that I could use that I was hoping the cable company would be able to look at that and say, oh, okay, yeah, we can definitely see that you have a problem, and that would help them out. So I spent quite a bit of time trying to get familiarized with it and everything, and once I finally felt comfortable enough with it that I could run it and be able to get the results that I was looking for and show that to them, guy shows up. I was like, hey, look, you know, I've got the ping plotter here. It's showing me that I'm losing packets. Here's where I'm losing them at. And it seems to be at the third or fourth hop. It wasn't right at the tap. It seemed to be, you know, a little bit farther out than that. And he looked at me as like, I've never seen this program at all. You know, this doesn't help me at all. I was like, well, I don't know what else to do. I could ping the servers and stuff like that. And he's like, oh, I don't even know how to do that. I was like, oh, great. Well, so much for all this. You know, I've got all this information here, and it doesn't seem to help you guys fix the problem. So I got severely burned out on doing all that. I got a couple of people there. Looks like they're just now getting on. We'll go ahead and get over in this lane, because I don't know how slow they're going, since he just, well, is he going to be in our lane now? And of course, I'm taking up two lanes. I think we'll just follow them. Looks like they're going decent. Well, now they're getting off. Go figure. Yeah, there's one thing we didn't do is upgrade our truck. I forgot all about that. Might do that after the end of the run, or we might save it for the next episode. We'll see. That was a rough one. What other issues have I had this week? So we talked about the controller, the recording issue, the internet. I guess just snow in general. Not a fan. You know, I like to see it and all that. It's just knowing it's that time of year, I'm not a fan of cold weather myself. You know, I think snow looks awesome, but I don't like being out in it. We're struggling getting up that hill. I think I'll just set the cruise control and let her go. Did it set? No? There we go. I think I took it off, maybe. I don't know. So we got another 15 minutes. That's going to be quite the trip. And I would like to get all this up in one episode. I don't know. We'll see. I don't know if that's going to finish it out or not. It's only 500. Well, yeah. that should get us our achievement, because I think 500 kilometers is, oh, without pulling out the calculator, should be about 2,000 kilometers. I'm sorry, I said that wrong. 500 miles should be 1,000 kilometers. It's pretty close to double. I think it's like 1.2 or 1.5 to 1.8, something like that. I can't even remember. It'll be close. Hopefully we'll get it. Oh boy. Wasn't paying attention to the signs. Alright. I guess we go back to the cable company and all that, since I've been dealing with it. One issue I have with it is the prices of the internet. It's getting pretty crazy. I mean, by the time you add internet and wanting to watch just the basic cable itself, maybe you add a phone line or something like that, you're paying almost as much, if not more in some cases, than you do the rest of your utilities combined. It's crazy. The prices have just shot up so much in the past. Another thing about that is they're pretty much almost unregulated. I mean, you know, for your electric bill, your gas bill, and all that stuff, you know, you've got meters. Well, at least most of us do. I don't know about everybody, but most of us have meters out there in the front. You know, if we have a problem with our gas, you know, they're saying that we're using this much. We can actually go out to our meter and say, yeah, okay, you know what, we're not actually using that much, and be able to at least have a way to prove that. With internet, you know, they could say, okay, well, you're getting 50 megabytes download. We can't actually prove that. I mean, we can go to the speed test and run the speed test. We can, you know, ping the server and see how long it takes and all that. But outside of that, we have no way to prove that we're actually getting that much. And another thing is, they don't guarantee that you get that much. They say that you're going to get up to that much. And that right there would drive you crazy. I can understand, okay, you sign a package that says, oh, 50 megabytes download speed. And you sign on to a package, and maybe you only get 48, maybe you get 49. I could see that. Maybe you get 48 today, maybe you get 52 tomorrow. That is understandable and reasonable. But when you hop on one day and you're down to 10, 25 megabytes, that is getting, you know, that's pretty bad. Regardless of whether or not there's a problem, and it's not, if there is a problem and it's not your fault, how long is it going to take them to fix? Are you going to get, you know, you don't get a rebate unless you actually call in and say, you know what, I'm having a problem, it's your guys' fault, you know, I expect, you know, can we get like some kind of rebate or something like that? Unless you actually call in, no, you're not going to get nothing back. You won't hear nothing from them. That drives me nuts. There's no way for, it's, like I said, it's pretty much unregulated. So your only option at that point is, okay, it's taken them a month, the problem's still not fixed. It's definitely not my fault. It's, you know, it's somewhere on their end, you know, what, be it a messed up tap or noise in the line or whatever. The options you have are to pretty much disconnect your server or disconnect your service and go with somebody else. And that is another whole issue itself, because you're limited to what services are provided in your area. And in a lot of areas, you only have two, maybe three choices to go with. And are they going to have the speeds that you're looking for? And some people are down to almost in a monopoly, you know, only having one choice. but I guess in a way it is convenience. It's not something that is required yet, but you know, we're evolving so quickly, it's almost getting to the point where it's mandatory for you to have either TV or internet, or you know, phone. The phone in itself, the phone companies are kind of leaning more towards going towards giving that away to the cable companies. Yeah, there was one point in the I was sitting there running the speed test and all that, and I actually dropped down so low when I called the cable company. I was like, you know what, hey, do you guys have a dial-up version? I mean, not a joke, I was down to kilobytes. Forget megabytes, I was down to kilobytes. It was that bad. One thing I did find interesting is they're giving out the packages to upgrade your service from the megabytes to the, now is what's coming out, the Gigablast, I believe it's called. And I was sitting there reading on the forums about the Gigablast, and people were dismayed about that because they weren't getting the speeds that they should be getting. They said when they first hooked up, everything was running pretty good, but then for whatever reason, something happened, and instead of getting the full uploads, they were getting about, I think one poster said he was getting 8 megabytes upload. I was sitting there looking at that, I was like, wow. I mean, not only is that guy paying out the wahoo for a better service, it was interesting to see that he's paying for a better service, he's not getting it, but yet his speeds went from, he said before he signed up, he was only getting like 2 or 3. And then after he signed up and then he started having problems, he was getting 8. I was like, well, I wonder if he downgraded, if his speeds would have gone back down to getting 2 or 3, or if he would have maintained the 8. That would have been interesting. I'm just kind of looking on my HUD here to see if there's a way for me to tell when my cruise control is activated. I'm not seeing it. I think on one of my other trucks there was. I'm not seeing it now. Okay, let's just go ahead and speed back up and I'll reset it. Yeah, I think one of my other trucks had a light that came on that let me know cruise control was on. Of course, saying that, there is a way to change the HUD. Let's see if I can find it. Hopefully I don't drop my trailer. Okay, it's not B. Okay, never mind. I don't want to be pressing a whole lot of buttons and end up dropping my trailer by accident. I feel like this whole trip has been nothing but me sitting there griping about internet services. Rightfully so, though. There, you know, like I said, there needs to be a way to see how much you're getting and pay for what you're getting. Of course, you know, there is computer issues and all that, but if they inserted, kind of like what you have for your gas lines, a deal right outside of your house that would say, okay, yeah, you're getting this or you're not getting this. Of course, then cable companies would gripe about that because of the money they'd have to spend. But, you know, that could be something that they could put on, maybe not necessarily on each house, but maybe on each tap. And you could go to the tap line and see it. That might work. I'd still rather have it on each house, though, similar to the gas lines. Oh boy. Yeah. Shouldn't have been going quite that fast, or maybe I should have been paying more attention. I could have taken it a little bit better. This truck feels a little bit quieter than the last one. Uh-oh. Yeah, let's go ahead and slow down a little bit. Yeah, a little bit too much there. I was trying to get it down to 50. things. I wonder if they updated it. I'm looking over on the right hand side where the bed is, and it's kind of a bluish color. Hopefully that doesn't interfere. In the past it has not interfered with the multiplayer server, but we've had quite a few updates, so I don't know. It might have actually started finding people for it. Not necessarily getting the black screen, but at least finding. That would be interesting. Wasn't a fan of the whole black screen thing. It was different and exciting in a way, but I wasn't a fan of it. Losing control of your vehicle while you're driving down the road. Of course, that's my fault for not pulling over and hitting the rest areas when I should have been. And I would pull over and rest, but I'm not sure exactly. CRE. Estimated time is 8:30 in the morning Monday. So if I can remember how to pull up the interface, is it F7? No, F6. It's expected at 8:47 p.m. So we should technically be able to sleep for 12 hours and still be okay. So we might do that. We might find a rest spot and pull over. If we can actually maintain to be able to stay on the road here. Oh, my driving is just awful. I really need to get one of those steering wheels. I'm not saying that it would help me, but hopefully it would be a little bit better. Thumbsticks can be a bit tricky at times. I didn't set up the horn. Actually, we don't even have an air horn yet. Hopefully I can remember to buy one. See a good area to. I don't want to pull off here. I don't see a good area to rest at yet. Yeah, I don't see one there. Maybe when we switch highways, there might be something close by. Yeah, we should definitely have plenty of time. Go ahead and get over so we don't interfere with that guy. This is one thing that drives me nuts. I see this happen. Oh boy, and he went all the way over. Alright. Slowed us down there a little bit. That's alright. We'll just follow him if he'll maintain at least 50. This is where we need to get off anyways. Yeah, I see that happen a lot of times. Hang on, let me make this turn first so I don't mess up, even though I kind of am messing up. Wow, that was some bright lights. Give some speed. We do have somebody behind us. Try to concentrate, make sure I stay in my lane. following this guy for a while. It looks like we have a turn coming up as well. I'm not the only one that has problems staying in my lane. That's probably fast enough. We do have a turn coming up. Speaking of which, I guess we should probably start slowing down. Quite a bit, because we need to almost come to a stop to make that turn right there. There we go, that wasn't too bad. Okay, back to what we were talking about. Yeah, driving down the highway, I see a lot of times where there's not very much traffic, but people do not want to get over and let you on. You know, they pretty much just stay the same speed they're going, which they're technically supposed to do. You know, they could get over into one lane to let you get on, if they're assuming there's nobody coming now. We're just, you know, talking about one or two cars. You know, they could get over and let you on, because some of those on-ramps are ridiculously short. And it could be kind of rough. You know, you're sitting there, you're trying to get up to speed, but you got somebody that's, you know, they don't want to change lanes to let you over, so the only other option you got to is to, you know, either really get down on the gas and almost literally cut them off, or to hit your brakes. An on-ramp is there for a purpose, to let you get up speed to get onto the highway. Country road here. Well, that's a nice quiet drive, and this kind of looks like it would be a rough road. I expect a little bit more noise than this. Maybe show the truck bouncing just a little bit, not much. Some cases they kind of overdo it. Not this particular game, just the games in general, whenever they go to make rough terrain. I can't tell, is that guy coming at it? Yeah, he's coming at us. A bit too fast for a two-lane highway. Definitely a little too fast for breaking the speed limit there. Yeah, 45 should be fine. Might actually crank her up to 50 once we get out of all these curves here. Just don't want to be going so fast that I end up getting over into that other lane, because I don't want to mess with oncoming traffic. And of course, going uphill, we are definitely slowing down. Gas station, I wonder. Yeah, it looks like there's a rest spot there as well. We'll go ahead and see if we can take advantage of that. We are about 14 hours ahead of schedule, so a 12-hour nap shouldn't hurt too much. As long as we don't wreck in between then and now. Shut it off, parking brake, and fill her up, please. Looks like somebody else is taking a rest. Interesting that he's got a double name up there. I don't understand why I'm seeing his truck and his trailer unless he disconnected, baby. Doesn't look like he's disconnected. That is strange. Wonder why it's showing both his trailer and truck. Alright, turn her off and catch some Z's. Alright, get back on the road. Oh, and it's raining. How do I turn on the windshield wipers? It's been too long. There we go. Actually, go for a little bit quicker. Oh, parking brake. No wonder we ain't moving. Here we go. It would be interesting if they also showed your brakes heating up. You know, if you're trying to drive with your parking brakes on, you're going to heat those brakes up pretty quick. I think maybe they should show a meter down there, and if your brakes get too hot, they go out. They probably don't want to do something like that in multiplayer. I don't know. I think it would make it for interesting. If they got so hot they'd go out and you'd have to pull over and let your brakes cool down or something before they'd start working again. And if you did it too many times, it would actually show some wear on there and you'd have to get them repaired or you would not have brakes. I think that'd be some good content right there. Nice quiet tunnel. Well, there's almost no sound right there. Let's see if we can't get the right hand side as well as the road at the same time. Probably not, but maybe. No, it doesn't look like it. So that is an area we'll actually have to pull off and get next time, or sometime. Alright, so we need to be in the right lane, it looks like. Maybe. No. I can't tell. Let's go with it. It's kind of doing some weird stuff right there. I'm not sure which lane I was supposed to be in. It looks like I was supposed to be in this one. Yeah, I don't understand why it was telling me to go both places. Probably because that waypoint, maybe I didn't put that waypoint exactly where I needed it to be. Yeah, let's go ahead and get over. A lot. Oh, I'm glad nobody was around. Yeah, I think that waypoint was messing everything up. I need to be a little bit more careful when I set those next time. We got another 7 minutes, so that's about halfway there. I think 55 will do it. Let's actually get in the lane we're supposed to be in. Yeah, we got a toll booth coming up. Let's see if we can coast right through it. Hopefully if it'll give us the option. It looks like this one will work. You know, it says you can go through it at 30 miles an hour. I don't know. That was 18 miles an hour right there, and I have a feeling if I was going 10 miles an hour faster, I probably would have hit that rail. I don't know. Because it wasn't going up very fast. Let's go ahead and side skirt on the right hand side and open this one up. I might not have to. I might actually get both of them. No, it's not. Alright. Another issue I had. I went to return something, and all I had was the gift receipt. I didn't have the original receipt because, you know, when you get a gift, you get the gift receipt, right? It turned out that it wasn't something I was going to be able to use, so I decided I was going to go ahead and take the gift receipt and put that towards something else. Well, when I did, I went up there to do that. It was for a game that wasn't out yet, right? So the game's not out yet. I've got the gift receipt. I want to change it in for something else. Now, when I went to do that, I told the lady, okay, I've got a gift receipt for this item. I don't want to pick it up because obviously, you know, it's not out yet. I just want to put that towards this over here. And she looked at me. She took the gift receipt and she said, well, this game, I can't do that without the original receipt. And I said, okay, well, let's do things differently. I said, okay, well, can you give me the money back for the gift receipt? You know, I've got the gift receipt here. I'll just take the money and I'll, you know, take care of things separately. And she said, okay, we'll do it that way then. And she pulled up the information. She said, hang on, you know what? I can't do this. The game's not out yet. I was like, yeah, I know the game's not out yet. I just thought, you know, I want to get the money for it. I don't want the game. It was a big long mess. Anyways, yeah, she couldn't do it without the original receipt. So, I don't even know where to begin with that. It was a whole mess. Ended up having to get the original receipt just to be able to do that. Looks like I need to be in the... No, right here. This will work. Definitely not that fast, though. Oh, slow her down. Are we going to hit the rail? Okay, cool. Yeah, maybe you can go. I don't know. That was 20 miles an hour. I'm kind of afraid to push 30 miles an hour going through those. Okay, sitting here thinking about the gift receipt. Yeah, okay, I remember now. When I went to give her the gift receipt, she said, you need a purchase receipt or something like that, you know, a different kind of receipt. And I was like, what in the world? Receipts I've never even heard of. You know, you got your original sales receipt, your gift receipt, and then she said I needed, in order to exchange it, I was going to have a purchase receipt. And I was like, what is this? I've never even heard of that. Yeah, it was quite the mess. But it ended up, when I got the original receipt, of course, there was no way I was going to go back to that particular store and end up messing with her again. I'm just trying to figure out exactly which way I need to go, because that, as you can see, that is looking a little bit messed up there. Need to be careful here. I'm going to hug this right hand side because we got somebody coming up on us. I hit that sign. Yeah, I didn't want to interfere with his driving. Didn't mean to hit the sign, but I didn't want to get on the highway knowing he was coming. Purchaser's receipt. Let's go ahead and pull in here. Get that gray knocked out. Oh, way too fast, though. kind of a last second decision there. Glad there wasn't nobody around. So we can catch up to that guy. We'll just trail him for a while. Not too sure if we're going to be able to. It looks like we are catching up to him. Don't want to go too quickly though, because some of these turns are a little sharp right in here. Pretty good speed. I wish I was a little bit quicker. I could catch up to him.
Benim işim tamamdır ya. Ben park ettim.
Oh, I forgot to turn that off.
Bekle, ben yarım saatte park ederim. Bekle.
Oh, I need to fix that.
Hadi bakalım. Anneler var mı?
Yeteneksizlik başarılarından akıyor böyle.
Sorry about that. I'll try to edit that out.
Turn off.
Tırcı neredesin tırcı?
Dur çıkma çıkma. Yavaş çıkma.
If I don't edit it out, I'll try to edit it out. If I don't edit it out, I'll ask for it. I'll at least try to make sure that it's not quite that loud. I really do need to make sure I get that edited out though, because A, I couldn't understand what they were saying. And I don't really want language on my channel, so. Can't believe I forgot to turn the CB off. It's messed up. Let's actually go ahead and pull over right here and take care of that. Now, if I can remember how to do that, I believe it's tab.
Nereye gidecektik?
There we go. Yep, sorry about that. I totally forgot about that. Like I said, hopefully I get that part edited out for you guys. Just having that CB on there, it was a bit loud. These country scenes, or not, sorry, not country, city scenes. All these buildings all lit up. And you can actually go slow enough to actually kind of admire it for a change. And we made it all this far, and I didn't even look to see what our cargo is. Looks like it's a not a tractor, a excavator. So that probably weighs it. I'm gonna say about 40,000. Is that right? It's been a while since I've towed one. We'll look at her here in a second once I get straightened out. Get around this guy. Looks like I got a couple of curves to go around. Oh boy, oh boy, oh no! Well, there goes our wreck. Oh, poor guy. What did we take, about 3% damage on that? Yeah, at least it wasn't our fault. I was going a bit fast, but I wasn't going too fast. I couldn't control my vehicle. I was going so fast, though, that I couldn't avoid the wreck, and that in itself is a problem. Is this guy in our lane? No, he's just stuck. Trying to get up a little bit of speed because we do have somebody behind us. It may get to the point where I slow down and just let them pass if there's a nice spot to be able to do that. Because I don't want to hold him up. Yeah, we're moving at a decent speed. Second, I thought that was railroad tracks. Yeah, I think 60's good enough. He can pass us if he wants to. I'll slow down if he starts getting up there. That actually might be a little too fast for that curve. Pick that speed back up. As I was looking again on Steam trying to find something to play, I did run across a really interesting game. If you've ever heard of, was it Heaven and Hearth, I believe is the name of it. Real old game, 2D game. I have played it, I've probably put about 20 or 30 hours into Heaven and Hearth. And then came out a game called Salem the Game. Now that's, don't confuse that with the one that's on Steam right now. The one on Steam right now is not even close to the same game. And Heaven and Earth has a ton. Don't tip over, dude. Nice. Oh boy, those guys are going quick. It just feels like they're going quick. I'm sure they're probably going about the same speed as I was. And our turn's coming up pretty close. I guess we'll save Heaven and Earth for a whole nother... Oh, wow, that's rough. Glad you don't take damage on that. Let's go ahead and start slowing down. I realize there's people behind me, but I've got to make sure I make this turn. There we go. Hopefully I didn't upset those guys. Looks like everything went alright. Yeah, we'll save Heaven and Hearth for another game topic there. Give us something to talk about next time. And I don't know if we got our achievement. It doesn't look like we got our achievement. I was hoping we did. I'll have to look after everything's over with. Where do I need to put it? I need to put it right. That can't be right. Surely not. I can't put it right there. There's a trailer there. Maybe I need to go back to the marker and actually get a drop-off spot. That's probably what it is. Am I going to be able to turn this thing around here is the question. I know it can be done. The question is whether or not I can do it. Maybe. Hold my breath or something. Yeah, I think we can do it without jackknifing it. Of course, I probably hit the guy behind us. Fortunately, we're in a no collision zone. A little bit of a jackknife, but it worked out. Actually, it's showing it to be over there. I wish I could get out of my truck. I'd go and look. Let's actually try to go back to the pickup spot, which should have been right here. Okay, never mind. Let's go ahead and turn around one more time. Kind of cheaty, but not really, because in real life you can stick your head out the window. I was looking for the green flag, but didn't see it. Ah, there it is. So I get to turn around one more time. Oh, this is going to be a fun one. Yeah, and I so did not get lined up for this. Yeah, we're gonna end up jackknifing it. Get her done though. I don't know, that fence is awful close. Come on, we got this. Nice. Alright. Just get her straightened out. I'll probably have to back up one more time, probably. Maybe two more times. I think this will do it. Once I get it straightened out, we'll be good. Straight back should do it. Nice. And there's our achievement, Test Drive Limited. Actually had to drop off the trailer to get the achievement. That's alright. Need to find us a decent little parking spot. That's the green icon I was looking for earlier. I wonder why it wasn't there. It's a little confusing. Some of the ones that we've gone to, I actually had to go back to the icon in order to find a place to be able to drop off the trailer. So I'm not sure. Maybe it's only certain areas that have that ability to do it in. I think this will make a decent parking job. So how much money do we end up with? $247,000. I think next time we're going to... I'm definitely going to upgrade our truck. I'll have to figure out what I'm going to do besides that. So, anyways, we knocked out that achievement. I look forward to trying to figure out what our next achievement's going to be. Until then, hope you guys had a good one. Scully signing out.